Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about polymers. We know polymers are there in every sphere of life. The importance of polymers are more highlighted nowadays because of its various applications in different areas of science, industries, and technology. And we have to discuss about the different types of polymers, the different classifications of polymers. Okay, we know that there are so many products are there in our day-to-day life. The clothes we wear, the packaging materials, the pen, paper, whatever it may be, that is made up of polymers. It's in and around us in our day-to-day life. These are some pictures of the different materials used in our day-to-day life. What are polymers? We know that the polymer, that is a Greek word, which is made up of two words, poly and mer. Poly means many and mer means meros. Meros means units or parts. That means polymers are macromolecules which are made up of many units. These small units are called monomers. The conversion of monomers to polymers is called polymerization. So, polymers are macromolecules which are made up of small units called monomers. The conversion of monomers to polymers are called polymerization. And we have several polymers, natural rubber, plastics, resins, and lots of fibers, the nylons, polyesters, different types of fibers at all. And we will discuss what are the different types of polymers. And what are the advantages of polymers compared to other materials? These are the important advantages of polymers. One is corrosion resistance. Compared to metals and all, polymers are used in every engineering applications and all only because of this corrosion resistance property. And these are lightweight. That is why we are using these materials for packaging applications. Then we can make any complex shape because of its processing technology, and it shows good electrical and thermal insulation and transparency and recyclability. Imagine some of the polymers that can be recycled. There are different classifications. First classification, that is based on origin. Based on origin, polymers are classified into two categories: natural polymers and synthetic polymers. Natural polymers, it is already present in our body. Our hair consists of proteins, our nail proteins, and our body contains lots of proteins. So all these proteins are made up of small units. These small units are called the proteins. The monomer of proteins are amino acids. Okay, muscle protein, then hair protein, keratin, that is also a polymer. And we know natural rubber. We are extracted natural rubber from latex. This is another important, industrially important natural polymer. This natural polymer, the monomer of natural rubber is polyisoprene. Okay, polyisoprene. And you know that the exoskeletons of shrimp, crab, etc., that is made up of another important natural polymer, that is called chitin. And that chitin, it is a wonderful material. It is really a precious gift from nature that is used in various applications, especially in biomedical field. Okay. So natural rubber, proteins, starch and cellulose. You know starch and cellulose. These are also natural polymers. Starch is made up of alpha D glucose and cellulose is made up of beta D glucose. So, based on origin, polymers can be classified into two. One category, natural polymers, and the other one, synthetic polymers. All the other commodity plastics, that means polyethylene, polypropylene, and polyvinyl chloride, all the synthetic, those are synthetic polymers that we can prepare in our laboratory. Okay. So, scientists can copy the structure of natural polymers and they can prepare the polymers inside laboratory. So, a variety of synthetic polymers are there: nylons, polyesters, polyvinyl chloride, polystyrene, etc. And the another classification that is based on the intermolecular force of attraction. second classification, that is based on intermolecular force of attraction. Based on intermolecular force of attraction, polymers are classified into three: elastomers, fibers, and plastics. Okay, elastomers, best example, natural rubber. Natural rubber, when you give a stress, we can stretch it. That means it is highly elastic in nature. That is because the intermolecular force of attraction in between elastomers is very weak. There exists weak intermolecular force of attraction. Those materials are called the elastomers. And we know fibers, nylons, then polyesters. These fibers, they have strong intermolecular force of attraction. And plastics are the group, the intermolecular force of attraction is in between elastomers and fibers. Okay. So based on intermolecular force of attraction, polymers are classified into three: elastomers, fibers, and plastics. Elastomers having weak intermolecular force of attraction, fibers have strong intermolecular force of attraction, and plastics, they have intermediate intermolecular force of attraction between plastic elastomers and fibers. Okay. And plastics are further divided into two categories, that is based on their property towards heat. Plastics are divided into thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. What is the difference between thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics? When you heat a polymer, it will become soft, and on cool it, it will become harder. This type of polymers can be molded into any desired shape, and these are recyclable also. Such kind of polymers are called thermoplastics. On heating, it will become soft, and on cooling, it will become harder. These polymers can be molded into any shape. And best examples of thermoplastics are polyethylene, PP, polyvinyl acetate, polychloride, polystyrene, etc. And there is another group, that is thermosetting plastics. Thermosetting plastics, when you heat a thermosetting plastic, it will become a hard, infusible mass that cannot be recyclable. All resins are examples of thermosetting plastics. Bakelite, you know, phenol formaldehyde resin, melamine formaldehyde resin, urea formaldehyde resin. These are all examples of thermosetting plastics. So according to the heat treatment, plastics are further classified into two categories, thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. And we know that their importance in everyday life, we know it is in different sectors like transportation, electronics, building, and leisure, packaging, textiles, and substitution materials for energy saving, easier shaping, lower system cost. And there are advanced polymeric materials which are used in the area of electronics, like conducting polymers and light emitting polymers. And packaging purpose, you know, we are using several polymers. In another important area, plastic application, the fourth sector, that is biomedical field. In biomedical field, lots of life-saving machines are made up of plastics. Okay, this is a heart valve, abu heart valve. Okay, in automobile, when you consider a car, various parts are made up of polymers. Okay, these are the importance of the plastics in our day-to-day life. There are two types of plastics, and not only the commodity plastics, simple applications, we can also use as engineering materials also, advanced polymeric material, advanced plastics also. Okay, these are some important domestic uses, but we know that there are some disadvantages in case of polymers or plastics. These are flammable and poor weather resistance and prone to creep and stress relaxation and high coefficient of thermal expansion. And we know that most important thing regarding the plastics, it is non-biodegradable in nature. Okay, that is non-biodegradable. That is the most important thing. Only 2-3 polymers are biodegradable in nature. Majority of the plastics we are using in our day-to-day life, these are non-biodegradable in nature. So that's all related to the preliminary classification regarding polymers. Okay, thank you.